Yeah, I was gonna go do some yabbying with my homies, man. You ready to do some yabbying, man?
Yeah.
You wanna go catch some yabbies?
Yeah.
What about you, Jaya? You go catch some yabbies? Yeah. Let's do it. Let's go yabbying. Alright, so we're gonna make some yabby traps. This is what we're going for. So essentially it's just a cylinder, wire cylinder, two cones either end. Yabby crawls up this ramp, falls down into the bottom, and when he goes to get back out, he'll get caught in this area. So I'll show you how we've been doing them. It's an old design from when we were kids. Pretty straightforward. We did have some opera house traps, but they'd perished in the sun and they were just so brittle that all the yabbies crawled out. So how I've been joining them is just a hook in the wire in the end. Line them up. Here's the end up here. Get your hook through. Bring it back up the top. Make a loop. Now this is quite strong wire. I'm sure there'd be nicer ways to do it. You could also use cable ties if you liked. Pull them down. Once you've got your cylinder, you cut a semicircle twice the diameter of your trap. So double the length of this circle and then cut a smaller semicircle out. That's going to be our entrance hole. And you fold it around. You can use what wires here to help start it off. And this is going to go on the top of our trap. Like so, jam it in the best you can. Once it's jammed in, start folding over these edges. Now these traps will stand the test of time. You can leave them out in the sun, they're not gonna rot and become brittle. Where the opera house yabby traps, you know, they don't last too long. You hose them off, kick them in a shed, you'll get a longer life out of them, but most people end up putting them outside or, you know, throwing them in their trailer or what have you. So once we get to that point, all we need to do is cut a little door, a little square, with leave one section, that'll just flap up and then you have a little bit of wire to seal it off, and then you can just empty the yabbies out when you're done. So yeah, we'll give them a test, see if they work, and if they do, we'll be doing a cook up with them, with the yabbies. Alright, so here's our traps. Just got some little baskets with a piece of chicken in it. As far as bait goes, you can use meat. Seems like the best bait is dry dog food, but we don't have any dog food at the moment, so just using a bit of chook. We'll get these traps down in the dams and see how they go. Alright, so we're on our way to the third dam. We've been lucky enough that Sparrow has let us yabby the dams on his property, but you can get them in most waterways in Australia. They do like muddy water, the yabbies. The crayfish seem to like clearer water. The car just broke down. Oh, back. Yeah, so bigger dams seem to produce larger yabbies. But they do like little muddy streams and the odd little puddles they find. They survive the drought. During the winter they'll bury down deep. So summertime's the best time for yabbing. But yeah, let's check out this next dam. Show you what an emu track looks like. There it is. Quite a large print. Yeah, I'd say come down here for a drink. Well, here's our last dam. It's right next to the big one. It's the silt trap. Ribby! Come up here, mate. We're going to go to this other dam. Rib up.
Some activity in
there. Yeah, what's that?
Good question.
We should come for an eel fish here. Yeah, this looks like a good dam too. Alright.
Good boy.
River! Here he comes, the little bush boy. You coming? Come on, mate, up this way. With no fence on the other side. Alright. First homemade trap.
See how much luck we got.
Whoa!
Got a few.
They work.
Oh.
The traps are a success.
Couple.
Definitely some edibles in there.
Oh yeah. Four or so, five? Yeah.
Our homemade traps.
Yeah.
There you go, first one.
Sweet.
Bring the bucket over here, Riv.
Just gotta check the other one.
Alright, should we leave these for now?
Leave them in for now. Let's go check the other one. We're on a roll.
Yeah, they're not getting out. These traps are good for that.
Yeah.
Come on, Ribby.
That's so cool. Protein. Over here. We've had a damn wall blowout. What happens when you let trees grow in your dam around the dam wall, and you'll see here how the roots can compromise the integrity of the dam wall. Cut the trees off your dam. Here we are.
Oh, this is our next one, eh?
Next one.
The old 20-pound line seems to be holding, just.
Yeah. I'll dive in there after it if this doesn't, if that broke.
Look at the bubbles.
Yeah.
Oh!
Ooh!
Shockers!
Not a bad little haul there.
Shockers.
Most of them are ones. Tiny, but there's a few big ones.
Two biggies. Wow, they've somehow got the chicken out of the mesh.
Oh, really?
Wow, there's got to be 20 or 30 yabbies there. 20.
Yeah.
So we've got two keepers, really.
Yeah, maybe that guy.
Big. Yeah, that guy can come.
But yeah, the rest.
Right, we'll get these ones out, Ollery.
Cool.
Ruby, come have a look at the yabbies. Let him go, look, he's going away. Little bubble one.
Oh. A meat plant.
Whoa, there he goes. You held your first yabby, River. Yeah, they got their little nippers into the wire and opened it up. Pretty clever. Oh, nice one, Riv. Ripping them out. I got a good feeling about this side. There's holes along the whole edge. So these are a yabby hole. Yeah. Alright, the string is just there if you want to do the honours. You can dodge the rocks. Oh, bait got out. What's going on there? I thought this was going to be loaded.
They somehow managed. Oh, look.
Ah, they've got in there.
This wasn't tied off.
Ah. Spewing. Well, that was the first trap we made. We didn't go back and look at it.
That needs to be mended, like, thoroughly there.
All right. Well, let's take that one with us because it's got no bait in it anyway. One unsuccessful trap.
Damn!
We've got a bit of a hole there.
Yeah. Fix that and bugger up.
Alright. Got two traps in this, Dan. Oh. A bit of a snag.
Oh, a few just. Oh, there's one.
One. Yeah, a bit darker in here.
Two. Yeah, the colour changed a lot.
Well, we'll keep that one, eh?
I was wrong. Sparrow reckon this is a really good one.
Well, you said it always has water, but from experience, they look just like muddy water. That one seemed like it could have been sitting on a stick.
Sitting on a stick?
Yeah, because when I pulled it, it had resistance, so it could have been just sitting on top of a branch.
Oh, right.
That's why there wasn't many in. A couple.
Oh, yeah, they got that colour that they look like back in Madawi.
Real blue.
Yeah.
Clearer water.
They got the bait out. Oh, they smell like.
They've eaten it all.
Because weren't they saying they're vegetarian?
Yeah, but they seem to eat it because it disappears. There's a couple of keepers there.
Well, I doubt they dragged it out.
To maybe check for a hole in this one. Oh, we better take that trap with us too, I guess.
Oh yeah, how did a small number eat it and a lot not eat all of it before? But.
Yeah, it's interesting. Alright.
That's a bugger, I thought we were going to get more from this.
That's the luck of the draw.
That's the way it goes.
They've only been in a couple of hours.
Yeah, true.
Oh yeah, the door's open. This one's got no bait either. I'll just have to leave them there. Yeah. Off you go, little fella. Grow big. There's lots of babies. What's that bite, Ruby? And put him back. Mm-hmm. Hold his back. Got him. Boy. You watch him swim away. Say bye bye. Bye bye, Yabby. So we've got one in this dam now.
One trap.
This is the best dam I have. Can try and get some more traps in here.
Yeah, I think this is.
Alright, we'll go check the other ones.
Pick up the other.
Couple.
Couple more. Couple big ones.
Yeah, they seem to be holding a good size.
Mm. I think, but just about all of them are keepers.
Let this one go.
Yeah.
Off you go. You live another day. Every trap, Father, one with holes. Every trap's had yabbies in it.
Yeah,
that's just one
cool.
They all escaped. Did it snap?
Didn't snap.
How far in did you get?
I need a hook.
Just remember where the bubbles are. We've had a snappage.
What kind of branch?
Hmm.
Literally right there with the bubbles on.
Yep, I see.
Why is that rope? Oh, you're in.
I'll take the stick though. Getting deeper.
Nice one.
Yeah, she's loaded.
Thought it would do well.
Wow.
Just haul.
That's a lot.
Glad you got the trap.
Have a look at them.
None of them are babies, but...
That's a loaded trap. Grab this bucket.
Yeah, that's a haul. That's what you want.
Ooh, what a size.
Yeah, there's a few with good size.
So this is our little flap. So yeah, just open up here. So our rope snaps, at least we know it wasn't our knots.
Yeah, I was a bit embarrassed if it was my tying.
Yep, just flop them all out like that. At last dam, where we started. It's a good looking dam, this. Oh!
There's four.
Still a heap in there. The best thing is we know the trap's working.
Yeah.
You know, these are great little traps, they're not going to perish in the sun.
There's a few keepers.
Yeah, there. Yeah, a couple. This guy looks big enough.
Yeah, come out over here and...
They've eaten most of the bait. There's a little bit in there which might entice them overnight.
The bait? Oh, yeah.
What, do you want to grab that one, Sparrow? The last one? Lucky last honours.
Oh, it's our cruddy rope.
Well, that's strange.
That is strange.
Not one, isn't it?
One baby little one. Right at the end, that was it.
Oh, there we go. That's why.
Yeah.
Another hole. Well, we'll put the bait out of this one and that one and we'll...
That's this one. Oh, yeah, you've got one little one in.
Yeah, they've all gotten out through this hole.
Mm. Yeah, might have to do a repair on that one.
Yep. Yeah, definitely. We were kind of getting better at building the traps as we went.
Yep. No, they're fucking choice.
Yeah, they're great little traps, eh?
Good job on them.
That was the old design from when I was a kid. Still working.
Mm.
Alright, the rest can go back, I reckon. Well, there we go. We've got half a bucket of yabbies. Probably about a kilo and a half.
That juice.
2 kilo there.
All good.
Rightio.
Alright. So this is our haul. Our homemade yabby traps. Not bad at all.
Yeah, with a few faulty traps.
few faulty traps, definitely need a bit of repairing.
Grab a few?
Yep, let's chuck some in.
Where are the dead ones?
In the esky.
Oh, right.
Put some big ones in and throw them ones in. Well, let's... Look at this guy with no nippers.
You're disadvantaged.
Alright. Hook up number two. We're going straight up. Thanks, little man. Should be hot enough for one more.
Still, that knocks them out pretty quick.
Yeah. Alright, so in the water we have some vinegar, salt. I'm going to cook them for 8 to 10 minutes. Beautiful. I'm going to check the time now. Storing them in the pool, some fresh water. Alright. We'll come back when they're all done. Alright, so we're trying the plain boiled ones. And they are sensational. What do you think, Aiden?
Pretty amazing. It's like, reminds me of lobster.
Goes definitely lobstery prawn vibe. Much nicer than a prawn. And we cooked these for between 8 and 10 minutes. Which seemed to be on the money. It's perfect. And there they are. So day two, Yabbying. Back at the traps. Seems like there's been an eel making holes in our traps, so we're just going to reinforce them. We've got a set line in over here, so if there's one in there, we should find out. And if there is, I dare say it's going to end up on the dinner plate. But this is the silt dam. The big dam's just over that way. We're going to go check that trap. Rebait them. See how day three goes. This trap had minimal bait in it, didn't it?
Yeah.
Might still get a couple. Oh yeah. Beautiful.
Oh, that's some nice ones there.
Dark, nice size ones, yeah. No bait left. There's a few eaters in there. Look at that big stonker.
There's three good ones.
We'll check each of the big ones for eggs.
They're in too. Yeah.
Yeah, three keepers there, maybe four. Beautiful. That's alright for a no bait trap. Alright, we better check the eggs. See how this one's got its tail back?
Mm-hmm.
And it's not, it's walking with its tail in. I reckon that one would probably have eggs.
Eggs, okay.
Okay. You wanna keep this one? No, you can go back in. We've got enough. Just keep big ones. Drop by, little guys. Grow big and we'll eat you later.
Okay.
I said, grow big and we'll eat you later. How are we looking? Check the tail. No, that one's good. Let's have a look if it's male or female. That's a male. Yeah, I prefer to be just taking the males, eh? Then you know you got a good stock.
Yeah, well, you can run out of males too, but it would, you get an idea of what percentage is.
Yep, no eggs there. Looks like a male. Yep, that's a male. So, this one, if you count up three legs, there's no circles, so that's how you tell it's a male. Alright, we'll get some bait in this trap. And we got one more, I think, to check up here. Maybe that one had no bait in it yesterday too, though. Not too sure. Bait was in this one. This is the one I went in for yesterday.
This has always produced the best. Trap. Oh yeah, best, one of the best hauls again.
Chockers.
This guy's on the outside.
Oh, that's a big one.
You are eager. Oh, that's the biggest one for sure.
That's huge.
Big fella.
Wow, what a haul. Alright, let's get some of these back in. Just checking for eggs as we put them in the bucket.
Yep.
Right, last dam for day two. Oh, another successful homemade trap.
Another good haul.
Look at that, plenty of eating size in there. Lovely. We're going to feast up tonight, do a couple of different kinds of cooking methods. There you have it, beautiful.
Oh, last haul of the day. See how we go.
That
feels
heavy.
Phew. Yeah, not bad at all.
To run out of bait in this one pretty quick. Can't even see the bar.
Sweet. We've got a big feed.
Oh yeah, feast up. Alright, so another good tip. These yabbies are going to be in the back of the trailer. We used to do when we were kids, put grass on top. That's going to stop the water from splashing out. You can see just from before, we didn't go very far and it was all coming out. I think on the trip home, it's bound to potentially even splash out some yabbies. So, good bit of grass, that keeps them nice and quiet inside. They feel a bit more protected, and we're not losing any on the trip. Alright, so we're going to get our pot up to roll and boil. Throw our yabbies in for 1 to 2 minutes. Then we're going to cut them in half and put some marinade on and char grill them.
Hang them there,
Riv. Alright. Some light in there. Careful, Rivy. So they're in for a 2 minute boil. In the meantime, cornage. Alright, so par cooked. Straightening some ice. We'll cool them down a bit. Then we're going to chop them in half. Some of them have been in a bit longer than 2 minutes because we like to have a roll and boil. But if you want to know if they're cooked, see how that's separated? That means your yabby's cooked. I found if you chop them from the other side, it was a bit neater.
Head first.
No, just from the top.
That side or that side?
I thought cutting this side would be the go, but I done a couple and they didn't come out as nice. When I come in from that end, it was better. But give it a try, it's worth the test. Oh, that seems to be not the best either.
Softer this side.
Yeah. That's working nice actually. Yeah, I found it like squished him a bit.
Yeah.
I'll grab you a wash bar then.
Crushing him, alright?
Yeah, try the other side. Maybe. I think I come from the other way. Yeah, through the head first, get that sorted. And then finish on your tail. I'll grab you a wash bowl. So we've chopped him in half. Give him a quick bath, get some of the gunk out of their heads, and then they're going into this basket where we'll put a marinade on top, quick char grill, and then they're bloody beautiful. What do you reckon, Riv?
What do you reckon, Riv?
Reckon they're going to be alright, Rivy?
My camera!
Alright, so they've been blanched, they're cutting off. We've got a garlic butter going on here.
This is premium eating here.
Premium melting temp.
This time no fancy marinade, just butter and garlic powder.
That's where it's at.
Nothing wrong with a marinade.
What do you reckon, Sparrow?
Looks like good food to me, mate. Been alright so far anyway.
Yeah. Well, these come from your property, mate, so... Well, you put us onto the good sauce and we appreciate it.
Absolutely.
And we're trying to do them justice. These little sandwich things are great for fire cooking. You've got total control, especially anything marinated. If we were to put it straight on this Barbie plate, it'd be sticking and all sorts of mischief trying to cook it. Where with this, we can just move it around as we please. For instance, it's a bit hotter on that corner and we can just move that around as we please to make sure every little yabby gets a tickle of fire.
And butter.
And butter, mate, yeah.
We all know butter makes it better. Oh, look at that brushwork. It's an artiste.
Yeah.
Well, an artiste, mate.
In another life.
Oh, I better check if he's got ears. Yeah, he's got ears.
Yeah.
Sensational. I might just have to snavel that little bad boy as an entree. What do you reckon? Alright, well, when they're all done, we'll get a bit of... show you how they come out. Char-grilled yabbies with garlic butter. Can't beat it. Alright, so we flipped them. We're gonna get some nice caramelized butter on that bottom side. I'll just give you a little sneaky. Up in there. Whoa. What I like to do with these baskets is give them all a tickle. So you just keep moving them around clockwise, whatever tickles you fancy. If you think these ones on the edge aren't getting enough, you get them over on there. If you think them ones in the corner aren't getting enough, you get that on there.
Did you just give them a go on the barbie last night, or?
Last night we had them boiled, the night before we had them thin like this.
Oh, right.
So it was a marinade.
Yep.
Yeah, so this is the third variation of cooking that we've done. We've done plain, we've done the chili, the garlic, ginger, sweet soy, jaggery, coconut aminos, paprika. Yeah, one just jammed up marinade, and that was off tap. After that, we wanted to try the true flavour of the Yabby, so we had a curry last night with some just boiled up plain and a bit of lemon and salt, and they were just better than any prawn or lobster I've tried, I'll tell you that. And then tonight, we're going the good old-fashioned garlic butter.
It's That's inverted.
It's inverting time. Oh.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that.
I reckon they're done, eh?
That'd be done.
They're done.
Yeah, they'll go rubbery otherwise.
Yep.
Alright, it's time to fucking give them a try.
Oh, we want to paint some more butter on?
Yeah, give them another go with it.
Yeah. You want to hold that for a second, Sparrow, for us? I'm just going to chop up a bit of coriander up. Do you eat coriander, Sparrow? Not a fan, I know. A lot of people aren't a fan of the old coriander. I don't mind a bit of a fresh hit.
Mmm.
Take that off now, because that side's upper side.
Oh, the smell.
Oh, it smells like bloody Indonesia. Indonesia or Thailand, you smell that charcoal and seafood. Bloody sensational.
Another couple of years, mate, and I'll you'll be able to smell what you're filming on the camera.
I reckon so.
Mm.
That might be an invention of Sparrow's. You should patent it.
Guys, get yourself a little.
I tell you what, if I knew how to do it, I would.
Oh, me too.
You'd make a fortune out of it. Once it comes in.
I reckon you try one, Adon. I just want to just see how it goes.
Right, yeah.
He's a man, he knows his flavours, this man, so... if it tastes shit, you're going to know it.
Well, when me and Josh get together, it's usually exceptional.
Look at
that. That's not a bad little piece.
Isn't it?
Lifted that out like a prawn.
Well, that means it's cooked well. God help me.
Yeah. It tastes like lobster.
Doesn't it?
Right, yeah, give it a crack. It's fine, right. Big.
Do you wanna do me one up? Do us one up, brother man. Yeah, I reckon I can get a hold of that bad boy.
Yeah. Peel straight out.
Let's see how we go here.
Can you tell me, doctor, why I still can't get to sleep?
It takes me back to my first Indo trip when I was about 16 or 17. At Dreamland, staying in a cave, eating fresh seafood off the fire. But that was lobster, and here we are in Australia in Coonabarabran eating bloody yabbies. I'll tell you what, if you tried these, you'd be neck deep in mud trying to grab them out of the water yourself. Sensation. I think that's a win, boys. It's a bloody win. Thanks, Adon. Thanks, Sparrow. Oh, over and out. It's time to get the fingers dirty. Happy Yabby and peeps.